Well, apologies for the wind noise, it's howling a gale, there's not really much I can do about it. What I've got here is the two different wiring harnesses. This is the 12 volt harness, this is the 6 volt harness. There's quite a few differences. I guess you could chop it up and make it work, but I've got the spares bike, so I may as well just put the whole harness in. And I want it to be all 12 volt electric. I don't want any half and half. So things such as on the 12 volt bike, there's no on and off switch for the lights, unlike the earlier models. And that's because the design rules changed and you needed the headlight on at all times. So what I'll do, just to keep it standard and all the same, I'll use this switch gear. There are other differences. Obviously I've got a 12 volt coil where the CDI fits. It's different. The voltage regulator is different, a different number of pins where the alternator fits. The wires from the alternator are different. So there's quite a lot of differences. So for me, it's easy. Change the whole harness. Now with the engine, the top engine mount, the engine drops slightly. I can feed the harness in and the high tension lead from the coil through as well. And let's start putting the harness in place. First thing is the coil. I'll feed that through. Driving me crazy, that's one thing they don't tell you about Australia. The flies are absolute useless. Going in. Now the coil. Leave this one into it. It fits up underneath there and two nuts hold it in place. Me right for being a left-hander. I have to make a nut impossible to start. Turn the camera on. coil in place. Now what I'll do, I'll connect up the connectors for the backlight and the rear indicators. Well, work is progressing on the 6 to 12 volt conversion. I fed the wiring harness through. I connected up the rear harness that goes down to the tail light and the rear blinkers, the rear indicators. Also the ignition switch, that's pretty easy, and the alternator. Then I turn my attention towards the battery box. Let's have a closer look at that. As I said before, because of the larger 12 volt battery, I've used the 12 volt battery box. And as you may know, because of the room that the battery takes up, Honda mounted most of the electrics externally. And so what they did to cover all this up, they used this humongous side cover. It's massive. Look at the size of the thing. Much larger. Let's compare it to the 6 volt one. The 6 volt is much smaller, and what I wanted to do was make the bike, was fit the electrics so that I could still use the smaller 6 volt cover. So I made up a small bracket and bolted the regulator rectifier there, tied on the CDI there and the flasher relay there. So it all seems to look quite reasonably quite good, and then hopefully the side panel will fit. Well, the rewire is progressing pretty well. Yeah, I've got the usual basket of spaghetti in there, needs to be tidied up, but everything seems to be fine. Probably the only difference is the 12 volt bike has a different speedo, sits really high up, and that's what Aussie Post put on there so that the postal workers could see the speedo while having a bag full of mail hanging from the handlebars. But I like the older style headlamp mounted speedo as fitted to my bike. I wanted to keep that, and then the challenge that I've come up with is I've swapped the globes out for 12 volt globes, but on the high beam indicator, it's a different globe, and the holder, this holder, won't fit into this headlamp. So what I'm gonna have to try and do is source a different globe, a different bulb, a 12 volt bulb for that, or modify the holder in some way. Other than that, everything seems to be coming fine. Just the last wire to connect up for the buzzer. A lot of people disconnect the buzzer anyway. And then I should be pretty close to having a start. Well, I've completed the 6 to 12 volt conversion. It was quite a lot of work, but for me it was worth it. Should you do this? If you're going to buy brand new parts, brand new Honda parts, the cost would be just crazy. It will cost you probably the price of a second-hand bike. So I've had a quick look online at some of the prices, and you're looking at $1,800 Aussie dollars for virtually all of the parts. I was able to get around that by buying a donor bike, a cheap donor bike. And because I bought a donor bike, that meant I got everything I needed. So I switched the wiring harness. I was able to use a 12 volt headlamp. I used a right hand switch gear with no on off switch from the later model bike. I went for a 2 hour test ride yesterday. The electrics was perfect. And for me, it was worth it because the type of riding I use this bike for, long distance, remote area, I need to have 100% confidence in the electrics, especially the headlamp. Why would I bother doing it on this old bike? Well, I've got a few different posties, and this one is the raddiest looking one. It's rusty, it's scruffy, it's not very smart, but it's taken me a lot of places, and to me this bike, it's just like a pair of old comfortable shoes. It's something that I'm happiest when I'm riding this bike. And the conversion wasn't too bad to do. It can be done by really anybody with basic hand tools. If you've watched my channel for a while, you'll have realized by now the whole point of the channel is to show that you don't need a big fancy workshop and a lot of equipment. You can get by with just a fold-up little workbench and a few basic hand tools. I've completed the conversion. You can see from the left cover there the bulge where the pulse generator is. The bike ran fine, and we're now ready to do some more outback adventures. If you gain some value out of the videos, consider subscribing, help the channel to grow, and also ensure that you don't miss out on any upcoming future content. And now, as much as I enjoy fixing and working on the little posties, riding the bikes is what I really want to do. So I'll get my helmet on and off I'll go. Thanks for watching, thanks for your support, and I'll see you again in the next video.